Alright guys, this is Ken Tips. Today we are playing Batman Telltale Games' season finale. This is episode 5. This is the finale of Batman. So if you haven't watched my previous videos, watch them to get caught up on this one. So you're going to be sitting here and watching it for about an hour. It's going to be the full gameplay, guys. So let's get started. Okay, so people that have been watching it, this is what you've been waiting for, the finale. See what happens to Batman and see what happens to Vicky. Alright, here we go. It's gonna recap it and then we're gonna start.
It's obvious that's why Vicky hates you.
Your dad helped bump off her parents!
Why would my father have the Vales killed?
I never said he killed the Vales.
She was born in Arkham. Victoria Arkham.
So where are you gonna go?
I've got some other business I need to take care of.
What did you do?
I destroyed Lady Arkham's drugs.
The innocent people
were a small price to pay.
Oh, you psycho! Now you can do whatever you want to me, but Lady Arkham's plans are already in motion.
So Two-Face got to break into, burn down my mansion, Bruce Wayne's mansion, and he had the choice between taking on Penguin, or you have the choice between taking on Two-Face. So I chose Penguin so I can get my tech back, but
the
you can change those
is
things.
Still reeling from an explosion Mayor Harvey Dent set off that obliterated an entire city block and killed innocents. When questioned about his extreme measures, Mayor Dent said he'll use any force necessary to take down the Children of Arkham.
You're done, Gordon! Give up your badge and we'll let you live.
Meanwhile, his opponents are routinely silenced. The latest to speak out is Police Commissioner Grogan. He called Dent a murderer and a terrorist and demanded his immediate resignation. In response, Dent's enforcers attempted to arrest Grogan, sparking violence inside the precinct. These are dark days in Gotham. Our mayor promised us a better city, but delivers only more violence. How long do we let this Two-Face stay in power? How long can we... Hey, excuse me, you can't be in here. Hey, you can't do this!
Shut up!
Let me go! Hey, stop!
Time's up! You should have known better, Gordon! Now we nail your tongue to the precinct door by order of City Hall.
Just try me, you punks.
Just in time, Batman. Ugh. Mayor Dent's lost his goddamn mind. His enforcers have overrun the city. Apparently, our new mayor doesn't care much for dissent. He's ordered a purge of every honest cop we have left. Which isn't many.
Dent is a sick man. He needs to be stopped before he hurts anyone else.
Well, maybe you can get him some therapy. After you stop him tearing the city apart. Come on. The commissioner's still down there. Ugh.
Sure you're up for this?
I have to be.
Follow my lead.
In the lobby, the commissioner. They can't hold out much longer.
Commissioner, is he? God damn it! No. Not you two.
He died a hero, giving his life for Gotham. I'm sorry, Lieutenant.
This is not your fault. It's a bastard, Dents. Krogan was a good man. A family man.
Lieutenant Gordon! Gordon! Come in!
Sergeant Kelly! Report!
It's the mayor! At Wayne Manor. He's got hostages. And he's killing them one by one until Bruce Wayne shows. He says... Cops show up, he'll kill another. Batman shows up, he'll kill them all!
Kelly, get out of there!
Sir,
I'll let the coin decide!
Kelly! Damn it!
Get yourself to a hospital, Lieutenant. Alfred, are you safe?
Yes. I'm barricaded in the Batcave. I heard gunshots, but then Harvey's men disabled the cameras.
I have to face Harvey as Bruce Wayne. Otherwise, he'll just keep killing people.
Perhaps going as Bruce could be an advantage. Even without the suit, you're a formidable opponent.
I should be able to keep Harvey talking long enough to get close. Then I'll make my move.
It may be your best chance. I'll be standing by if you need me.
It's time to end this, Harvey. Once and for all.
I want a safer Gotham. A Gotham where working people can raise their families. Without fear of being robbed or stabbed or worse. I know I can make the city better. If only I...
Okay, I'll back you.
Come on, Bruce, that joke is in poor taste.
I'm serious, Harvey. I'll fund your campaign completely. I've lived in Gotham my whole life. And I've never seen an official I can believe in. Until you.
Thank you, Bruce. I promise, I will not let you down.
Mm-mm, never even crossed my mind. The only real question is, this election or next?
We'll let the coin decide.
Lucky. But someone has to die. Are you volunteering, Deborah?
Harvey!
Wayne! About damn time!
Snipers, two of them. Get the drones online.
I'll see what I can do.
I wasn't sure you'd come. I throw you in Arkham, burn down your home, and nothing.
Please, Harvey, let these people go!
Oh, you really think it'll be that easy? You're dumber than you look, Bruce. Maybe you'll look smarter with a bullet in your face!
Listen to yourself! This isn't you.
Wait. What am I saying? I've tried to fight it, Bruce, but I can't. Bruce, I only ever wanted to help Gotham. And now look at me. I can't stop him. He's stronger than I am.
Just put the gun down, Harvey.
You don't tell me what to do. No one tells me what to do. This city needs to be purged of people like you. All of you! Traitors! Terrorists! Cops who don't take their mayor's orders!
Harvey, don't!
This is the only way to clean up this cesspool!
No, please!
Girls! This is what happens to people who cross me, Wayne.
You were the fiercest DA the city ever had.
Someone who fought for people's dreams.
So much for a safer Gotham.
You're right. This isn't me.
Go. Go, get away!
I would let them all go, but... it's not up to me. Deborah, my not-so-faithful assistant. You've been feeding my enemies info since the start!
I swear I...
Beg all you want, but it's not up to me. Your life, his life, even my life. They all hinge on check.
You're weak, Harvey.
Letting a coin make your decisions.
It's not weakness, Wayne. It's strength. To accept there's something bigger than me. Bigger than any of us.
It's your lucky day, Deborah.
Now, Bruce!
Stay back! Oh, God, please don't.
Harvey, no more.
No more? I'm just getting started. This is the only way to keep people in line.
You're sick, Harvey. You think you can run the city after this?
You were Harvey's friend, Wayne. He thought you'd save this city together. But he was a fool for believing in you!
That's enough, Harvey.
You're right.
Two-faced move, I know. But sometimes, you have to make your own luck. One last call. A bullet in the head, or one in the heart. I'm feeling pretty good about those odds. Give me the coin. I need the result. Where do I shoot? Drop the damn coin! Without the coin, I can't. I don't know what to do.
I don't think so.
Bruce, I don't know what to do. I can't decide. That's too much. That's too much, too much. I can't.
A safer Gotham, Harvey. Just like you wanted.
Wherever they put me, whatever they do, I'll get out. I'm coming for you, Wayne. Nowhere is safe. You're gonna die.
I'm not worried, Dent. You go on and try it.
Oh, I will, Wayne. I will!
Mr. Wayne, I owe you so much. You're a hero, and I'm gonna make sure all of Gotham knows it.
You should be rotting in Arkham! Lady Arkham hasn't forgotten you. Everything you love will burn.
That was an exciting beginning, guys. So now the episode's really starting.
Your usual tea and the entire pantry, I'm afraid, didn't survive the fire. This is from my own personal supply.
Thanks, Alfred. We're not the only ones that took a hit while Mayor Dent was in power.
Well, at least you've ensured Harvey won't be hurting anyone else. Bruce, these last few weeks, I worry about the toll they've taken on you. Facing off against Harvey and Oswald in a matter of days. Not just the physical toll. Those were men you once trusted. And after finding out what you did about your father, people must seem a great disappointment to you. Always letting you down.
Not all people. You've never disappointed me, Alfred.
But I have. Everything that happened, I could have stopped it if I'd done something all those years ago. This is my fault. All of it. I told you I wanted to leave your father's employ. But if only I had the guts to do something instead. Your mother, she wanted that. Wanted to put an end to his crimes. If I'd helped her, if I'd stopped Thomas, none of these horrors would have occurred. Lady Arkham, Oswald.
I don't blame you for what happened, Alfred. You did the best you could in an impossible situation, and it helped to make me the man I am today.
I... Thank you, Bruce.
But our work isn't done. The children of Arkham are still out there, and Lady Arkham.
With both Penguin and Mayor Dent off the board, she's the only remaining piece.
We need to figure out her next move. The only thing we do know is that she moved on from her plan to poison the city. with Penguin gone and my CEO access restored, and finally log into Wayne Enterprises and see exactly what Oswald was doing during his time in charge. If I cross-reference that with all the data we have on Vicky Vale, we might be able to figure out the Children of Arkham's next move. Vicky Vale, mid-30s, reporter for the Gotham Gazette, and not in the public record, her true name, Victoria Arkham.
To think she was here, in the manor. She gave nothing away of her true nature then.
The Gazette's records of the articles written by Vicky Vale. This record isn't complete.
You're right. There are notable gaps between entries. But yet, it doesn't seem she ever left the Gazette's employ. So what was she doing in that time?
This record wouldn't be easy to alter. Seeing what Oswald was up to could give us a fresh perspective. The Children of Arkham. Their symbol dates back much farther than their terrorist activity. They formed to get justice for those wronged at Arkham Asylum. But the message fell on deaf ears. Until they found a leader Gotham couldn't ignore. Vicky embraced this identity to follow through on her twisted crusade.
Her mask inspires fear. Not unlike Batman.
I just need to find her.
Your administrative access to Wayne Enterprises should have been reinstated by now, along with your title of CEO.
Let's see what Oswald was doing while he sat in my chair.
Master Cobblepot's sense of humor hasn't changed much since you were boys.
Can we just see what he was doing? Penguin was tapping into surveillance systems across Gotham. Any building using Wayne Tech security could be spied on from the CEO's office.
How is that any different than the back door into the Wayne network that he uncovered?
That's not. Unless. Hold on. Oswald was trying to buy an island.
What on earth for?
Looks like he was using his new legal control of Carmine Falcone's assets and likeness to brand the place. Make it some kind of tourist attraction.
He was going to call it
Falcone Island. We need to figure out Lady Arkham's next move.
Of course.
Oh, Oswald certainly wasn't very frugal with my money.
You have a few yachts to return, it appears.
Also explains how the Children of Arkham had a seemingly endless supply of guns. Oswald was using Wayne money to arm them. Oswald altered several public records using the Wayne network. Oswald manipulated my records as well.
It would appear your degree was in sociology.
And my medical records.
There are some, well, but colorful diseases.
Annoying, but not hard to fix.
That's better.
No surprise here, Oswald wiped away any trace of his criminal records. His background is completely fabricated.
He was enrolled at Cambridge? Ridiculous.
Calm down, Alfred. I'm sure the board realizes by now that they were fooled.
All mention of her birth name, Victoria Arkham, is completely gone.
Wait. What's this?
He also erased something from Vicky's research at the Gazette. I can't tell what was removed from here, but Wayne Tech leaves a trace when it alters data. One the Bat Computer can decode.
What is it Miss Vale wanted to hide?
What do we have here? They did more than just look at these schematics. Every building in Gotham with a Wayne Tech security system can be accessed from here and remotely controlled. If Oswald was the brawn, Vicky is the brains. So let's check her file. She may have left clues about what she was using Oswald's access for. Now that we know how Oswald manipulated Vicky's records, the Bat Computer should be able to... There. No more holes. She was looking into Arkham patients. Reviewing records, checking submissions, prior histories. She was trying to figure out who was actually sick and who was committed because of Hill, Falcone, and my father.
Vicky was digging deep. Gotham City records, freedom of information requests, posts to conspiracy forums. All to find.
It's a list. Gotham buildings that use Wayne Tech security systems.
It's a list of targets.
City Hall, Arkham Asylum, GCPD headquarters, Gotham First National. It's almost every landmark in the city.
We're onto something.
Vicky wants to bypass the security at a Gotham landmark. But without a man inside Wayne Enterprises, she can't unlock that door remotely. She'll have to get her hands dirty.
And when she does, we'll find her. Speaking of...
Is it Lady Arkham?
No, it's one of Lucius's prototypes. On the move.
What? But Lucius locked everything away.
Well, he needed a better lock.
She stole from you? After we opened our doors to her? After all that you two...
Alfred.
Yeah, I know, Bruce, but... Why would she do this? Is she that cold-hearted? That selfish?
She must have her reasons.
Well, I'm sure she does.
Computer visual.
The prototype she stole. It's an electronic skeleton key.
With it, you could bypass any security system made by Wayne Tech.
That key is far too dangerous in Miss Kyle's hands, especially with Lady Arkham still at large.
Get the car ready, Alfred.
And Alfred, let Lucius know what's happened.
I'm going to get some answers from Selina.
I wasn't expecting you. Thought I'd make it outside the city limits, at least.
You should know by now not to underestimate me.
I thought you might be busy with, I don't know, saving the world. I'm flattered I rank so highly. But I know you're not here for me, are you? I don't blame you for wanting it back. I'm surprised you had a toy like this. No doubt Batman would use it for the good of Gotham, but the less noble options are so much more exciting. Why should I give it back? So much potential. Just imagine what I'd be able to dig my claws into.
That device is far too dangerous to be out in the world.
If Lady Arkham got a hold of it, that blood would be on your hands.
Wow. That's pretty dramatic, Bruce. Catch. You might be exaggerating, but I'd rather not take the chance. Oh, come on. Don't pretend you're not impressed. As long cons go, this one was a beauty. Getting into Wayne Tech's lab took a lot more than cracking a safe. I had to get close to people. Your friend Harvey. Poor guy just wanted to fall in love so bad. After that, it didn't take very long to get my introduction to his BFF. The great Bruce Wayne. Imagine my surprise when the rich playboy turned out to be Batman, scourge of Gotham. I was always going to steal from Bruce Wayne. I just never expected he'd be so interesting.
So it was all just an act. Everything we've done together. A lie.
That's how it started. And now it's over. I'm getting out of here while the getting's good. Gotham's a house on fire, and I'm not gonna burn with it. If you were smart, you'd get out of here too. This town hates you. Hates your entire family. Just leave it all behind. Do something more meaningful with those skills of yours. You don't need the money, but think of the fun.
Someday, yeah. Maybe I will be able to leave Gotham. But for now, I am the only one who can save this city.
So humble. It'll be good to put some distance between us. After all, look at what happened to Harvey. It'd only be a matter of time before I crossed one of your lines. Isn't that right? My copy of the Boy Scout Handbook is out of date. I'm bound to break some rule.
Selina, I would never hurt you.
Bruce, that's really sweet. But it brings us to the root of our problem, doesn't it? You're upset that I'm leaving. What'd you think? That one night of sex meant we were going steady? Is that what you really thought?
I had fun, Selina. Didn't you?
I'm all for fun, Bruce. But how long does this stay fun before you start wanting more? Look, Bruce. I'll admit that what you and I had... it wasn't terrible. But you were just another job. A more intriguing job than I was expecting. But still a job. And that job's done. I'm done with you. It's not complicated. I'm not a good person. I'm certainly no hero, and I don't want to be. I'm a thief. That's all I am. I told you that from the start. I never pretended to be anything else.
Stop. That's not true. I know there's more to you than that. You're just afraid to admit it.
You'd like it if that were true, wouldn't you? Why would you even think that? I've made my feelings pretty clear. Why aren't you listening? That's what I thought. Well, there's one good thing to come out of this. Now I know I was right. You really are just like everyone else. Can't wait to get out of this place.
Stay out of trouble, Selene. Because if not, I will stop you.
You can certainly try.
Lucius, I've got the key. Hold on, Alfred's on the line. Hey, Alfred, I...
Bruce! Lady Arkham! She's here! I tried to keep them out, but...
Alfred? Alfred! Alfred!
Lucius, it's Bruce. He's not here. Damn it.
I'm going to search for clues.
Just tell me how I can help.
Get over here as fast as you can.
I'm on my way. We're gonna find him, Bruce.
I know. Need to focus. Figure out what happened here. What happened to you, Al? Furniture scattered outwards from a single point. Ash everywhere. What did they do to you, Alfred? Something big was thrown against this wall. Or someone. Face was knocked over in the struggle. The fight left nothing untouched. This pool cue was used as a weapon, swung so hard it broke in half. Blood pattern looks like it came off a high velocity hit. The lock's been completely destroyed. Alfred must have barricaded himself in here. But they got in anyway. How the hell... A scuff mark. What could have caused this? These weren't scattered by the same event. I don't see a connection here.
Alfred used the pool cue as a weapon, broke it across his attacker's head. When that didn't stop him, he used the jagged end to stab, spraying blood across the pool table. Poker couldn't have made that crack. No. Lady Arkham must have used the concussion blast from her staff to try and stop Alfred. Alfred grabbed the fireplace poker to fend off Lady Arkham. She knocked it aside. I know what happened. The children of Arkham broke in. Alfred barricaded himself inside the parlor. He had just enough time to grab a pool cue as a weapon before Lady Arkham blasted the doors open. He broke it across one of their heads, then stabbed him to get away. Another assailant tackled Alfred, knocking over the vase. Alfred almost escaped, but then Lady Arkham entered the parlor. Used her staff's concussion blast, scattering all the furniture in her path, throwing him against the wall by the fireplace. So Alfred grabs the nearest thing to use as a weapon to defend himself. But Lady Arkham deflected Alfred's attack, causing the poker to fly across the room and lodge into the wall. More blood on the mantle. He smashed his face into it. Wait. That picture doesn't belong there. Lady Arkham wanted me to find this. Alfred. Butler did it. Password Reckoning. You have no idea.
What she's doing to him.
All right. Well, then let's get to work.
Alfred keeps adjusting his glasses. The reflection. He's making sure I see the reflection in his glasses. He knows the Bat Computer can use multiple reflection angles to recreate the room that he's in. and I can view the virtual image using my cowl.
Good thinking, Alfred.
Okay, Lucius. Freeze frame on the first signal Alfred gives.
Paint us a picture. Here we go.
Stairs leading up. Cement walls. We're in a basement. Alfred's trying to look at things that might give us a clue to where he's being held. Professional-grade camera. Probably came from the Gazette's office. He's wounded.
Must be one of the thugs Alfred fought upstairs.
Okay, looks like we've seen all there is to see in this frame. Let's move on to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
Rogers Plumbing. A service company for the water heater. I can use their records to find home addresses for their clients.
We're getting closer.
Yeah, but we're not there yet. Doesn't seem to be anything else here.
Let's keep looking.
Nothing else to see here.
Moving on.
A Mason stamp.
Only one Masonic lodge in the city. Gotham City Fraternal Order of Stonemasons.
So the house was built in 1945 by them. That's a big lead. Lady Arkham. Keep searching. Jump to Alfred's next signal.
You got it.
A basement window.
What's that outside?
Give me a second. They're by a bus stop.
There we go.
Okay, I think we have enough to pinpoint a location.
Let's hope.
Filtering for all homes built on that date. These are all the homes serviced by this water heater company on the days and months listed. I can get the bus line from this, but no stop number. This will help pinpoint the neighborhood. Bowling alley. Damn it. Let's keep looking. You are not going to believe this.
What is it?
Lady Arkham is back at the Vale House, where she killed her foster parents. According to its records, it has a basement.
Well, just in case she's expecting you.
What is that?
Something I almost didn't get to finish because of Penguin. It's the most advanced version yet.
Lady Arkham will have no idea what I've got up these sleeves. Well done, Lucius.
You've been long overdue for an upgrade. This suit is beyond state of the art. This ends tonight. Heading into the basement. Be careful. I'm all right. There's no one here. No Alfred.
Damn it!
There's blood on the walls. I'm going to see what I can find.
Standing by.
Alfred's blood is still fresh.
Means we can't be far behind them.
This is where they had Alfred. Where they beat him. Alfred, there's a boot print in the blood. Lady Arkham's soldiers dragged him. The trail stops at the wall. Actually, it goes under it.
Sounds like there's more to this basement than it would appear.
Taking a closer look. The wall is just a facade.
Why would the Vales have a false wall in their basement?
Now let's find out what the Vales were hiding. There's a small room. With a hole in the floor. A rope ladder.
Anyone down there would be trapped.
Alfred!
Going inside.
Bruce, what's down there? Do you see Alfred?
No. Some kind of torture chamber. Shackles, belts, blood.
What?
Vicky. She was kept down here, locked away.
Who could do that to their child?
I'm beginning to understand.
What is there to understand? To willfully hurt a child?
No wonder Vicky is consumed with hate. It's all she's ever known.
I can't even imagine, but it doesn't give her the right to take it out on others.
The Vales' foster children may not have been the only ones to suffer here. I followed Alfred's blood into this hole. If he had any opportunity at all, he would have left me a clue. There are drawings. Vicky must have drawn them when she was a prisoner. The chalk here is different, newer. Scratches, fingernails. Someone tried to climb out.
Alfred?
No. Disturbing. Vicky created her here, in this room. This
is where Vicky Vale became Lady Arkham. Shackles. Blood on them. Old. And new. Vicky did to Alfred what was done to her. One piece apart from the others. Purple. The same color as my tack. Can't be a coincidence. Maybe... That drawing looks like Alfred. The highlighted words read, "To Arkham." He left me a message using this chalk, but there must be more to it. This is what he wanted me to find. To see. He's modified one of her own Lady Arkham drawings to include himself. And these two words. To Arkham.
Then she's...
going to Arkham, and she's taking Alfred with her. That's the final piece. Arkham. She's been using Wayne Enterprises to get access to the buildings with Wayne Tech security systems. Including Arkham Asylum. She's going to open the doors. Release the inmates. And she took Alfred with her. Call Gordon at the GCPD.
I'm on it.
Lady Arkham won't be expecting us. We'll catch her by surprise.
Orderlies are rounded up.
That's the last of it, then.
The Children of Arkham have taken over.
That suits no slouch. You're well prepared for a fight. And the GCPD are on their way to deal with the inmates. If you can find Alfred, maybe you can get him out of there before all hell breaks loose.
Almost ready. Let her know.
Copy. On our way. Go ahead. I got this.
Batman! This ends now, Vicky. Tell me where Alfred Pennyworth is.
The butler. Bruce Wayne has a bat on his payroll.
Answer the question.
Where he is doesn't matter. He'll be dead soon. Another corpse in Bruce Wayne's family.
No one's dying tonight.
You really think you're in control here? Your confidence is impressive, but that won't save the butler or the rest of Gotham. A lesson needs to be taught. They won't look the other way. Not again.
And when did Gotham look away from you, Vicky?
Don't try to psychoanalyze me, Batman. You have no idea what I've done to come this far. Too much to turn back now. Enough of this. Your time's run out.
Vicky!
underestimate the true children of Arkham. These souls kept behind bars. Open the doors! Arkham! Listen to me! Freedom is yours! The only one standing in your way is Batman.
Batman?
The only one standing in your way is Batman.
Batman?
He stuck me in here!
Me too.
Let me out.
He's the crazy one!
Man, the sound in this is kind of choppy.
You're not getting away, Vicky.
Did he just hit some invisible guy?
Pleasure to see your work in person.
Batman! You see the invisible guy that just hangs up with just his mouth and teeth? Wow, Telltale Games really dropped the ball on this one.
There's no way out now.
There's always another way here, Batman. All the people that Thomas Wayne condemned to this place unwillingly, they speak through the walls. Their ghosts walk. They know the way.
I can't help those people now, but I can help Alfred Pennyworth. Take me to him.
My pleasure.
You're not well, Vicky. You need professional help.
Says the man dressed as a bat.
Let him go!
The butler has to die. Payment for Thomas Wayne's sins. He took away my family, so I'll take away his sons. If you really want to save the butler, bring me Bruce Wayne. If anyone can find him, it's you. He's probably cowering behind a 12-inch thick wall and 100 bodyguards right now.
I'll bring you Wayne. But first, let Alfred Pennyworth go.
No. Afraid he's too useful to do that just yet. You're doing so much for one old man.
Stop playing games.
This isn't a game to me. You know, Batman, I really don't understand. Why are you fighting me? I've done great things for Gotham. Falcone and Hill deserved to die. If anything, I did you a favor. We're fighting the same fight, Batman. Can't you see that? We want the same things!
Those men deserved their day in court, just like everyone else.
So they could have gotten off like they did so many times before? No, Batman. They got exactly what they deserved. My justice is final and absolute. You shouldn't be here. You shouldn't be defending him. You think Bruce Wayne is any better than his father? He hides behind his status and wealth. He's a coward, leaving other men to carry his burdens. You aren't my enemy, Batman. I'm curious, Batman. I know why I wear the mask. It's who I am, who I was always meant to be. What about you? Do you wear the mask to hide? Or to become who you really are? Are you the man or the mask?
Batman is who I am, who I need to be. To do what must be done.
If that's what you believe, you're lying to yourself. You wear the mask so that you can't be held accountable. And once you're dead, I'm going to mount that mask on my wall. But first, I'll see the man beneath.
Ugh!
Hold on, Alfred.
You came. You came for me. After what you said, I knew you'd come. The man I made you.
Just hold on, Alfred. Did you see where she went?
She just disappeared.
I'm getting you out of here.
Above you!
Interesting how you speak to him. So familiar, Alfred. Such concern for someone you've never met before.
It's called compassion, Vicky. Something you seem to know very little about.
Sounds like deflection to me. There's more here than you're telling. It makes me wonder, do you really care? Only one way to find out.
Batman, don't you...
Shut up, old man! You've seen my true self. Your turn. Prove that you can. Take off your mask. Let me see the man you really are.
If that's what it will take to save him.
No!
He'd never be the man Batman is. He only looks out for himself. Oh, but of course. Now I understand. As Batman, you can prey upon the weak, the defenseless, just like your father did. A true Wayne. There's nothing heroic about you.
I can't change what happened in the past. I would have fought for you. No one should have to suffer the way that you did.
You don't know how I suffered. But you will. I'll show you what Thomas Wayne did to me. To my family.
Thank you.
Oh my god. Damn it. You only had a split second to do that.
You belong in this place, Bruce. Lost. Forgotten. Buried. And Gotham will not mourn. The sins of the Wayne bloodline end here. Didn't remove your power. I think Val probably died, but that's weird if it did.
As to last week's events at Arkham Asylum, a spokesperson for the GCPD assured us that the breakout has been contained and all inmates have been returned to their cells. Miss Vale is missing and presumed dead following a gruesome battle with the Caped Vigilante known only as the Batman. Her death marks the end of Children of Arkham's reign of terror.
If the public knew the half of it.
It's better that they don't.
Any word from Miss Kyle?
And I don't expect I'll be hearing from her anytime soon.
With everything that's been going on, I haven't gotten a chance to thank you for what you did. Sacrificing your identity for my safety. But it was a dangerous thing to do. You could lose everything. The secrecy you've worked so hard to maintain, gone.
Without you, none of this would work. You are my family.
You don't know how good it is to hear you say that. After everything that's happened. And your ear? At least there's something left of it.
Dr. Tompkins assured me it adds character.
That it does. We will get through this, Bruce. Don't lose sight of the fact that you've done some real good for Gotham. You should be proud.
I didn't take them down alone. I had help. You, Lucius, Gordon, Selina, and all those who gave their life fighting for Gotham.
To those who helped, and those we lost.
The damage done by the Children of Arkham has left Gotham a city in turmoil. Faith in those at the top has perhaps irrevocably been shaken. Acting Commissioner James Gordon has promised to speak out about the issue tonight during an emergency citywide address.
And I hope, despite the recent terror that's gripped our city, that Gotham's leading citizens will come out to show their support.
Will his token appointment be enough to regain the city's trust? It remains to be seen. But experts agree that...
Gordon requested Gotham's leaders to stand behind him. Leaders like you. Let Gotham see who Bruce Wayne truly is, and let them know what you plan to do for its future.
Well, this could be a fresh start.
For you, and for this city. Though, in Gotham, the only figure that can make as much impact as a Wayne...
is Batman.
You've helped this city tremendously, both as Bruce Wayne and Batman. And that person, whether he dons a cape or not, is someone I'm proud of and honored to call my friend.
Thank you, Alfred.
So, what do you intend to do about tonight?
Well, Lucius has yet to invent a suit that'll let Bruce Wayne and Batman be in the same place at once.
That is unfortunate. I suppose you must decide whose appearance will be more valuable. As Bruce, you can help repair the damage done to your name, get the public support so that you can change things from the top down. But Batman is a symbol of justice and strength. Maybe in these dark times, that is truly what Gotham needs the most. Perhaps one is truly the mask, and one is who you truly believe you are.
All right, I think I'm gonna have to attend as Batman.
Bruce Wayne will be there.
You'll make
this is Bruce Wayne's story, actually, not more Batman. Be grateful.
Commissioner Gordon. He is here.
Commissioner Gordon. Yeah, it doesn't sound right.
Don't worry. It will. Thank you for having me, Commissioner.
What happened to your ear? It looks painful.
Cut myself shaving.
What'd you use, a chainsaw? Well, to be honest, I was surprised to get you a call. Now, after that nasty business at your manor, I know Harvey was a good friend of yours. A loss like that, I wouldn't blame you for lying low. What you did is no secret. These people all saw there's more to Bruce Wayne than just the playboy. Public opinion is bound to swing around. Before long, you'll be Gotham's golden boy again.
It's time I owned my family's past. Take responsibility for what my father did, so we can all move forward.
No, that can't be easy. But I'm glad that you're here. I was half hoping Batman might show up, too. I wouldn't mind knowing he was keeping an eye on things here.
If Batman isn't here, then it's because he's more needed somewhere else. I wouldn't take it personally.
Yeah, good advice when it comes to that guy.
They're ready for you, Commissioner.
Now, during times like these, it can feel impossible to hold on to hope. But I have hope. Hope that together we can rebuild what was lost. Now, in the last few weeks, as much violence and terror as I've seen, I've also seen the citizens of this community band together to fight those threats. And one of those people is Bruce Wayne.
Thank you, Commissioner Gordon. Tough act to follow. I'm here today to not only show my support for our acting commissioner, but also for this city. Many of you have suffered terrible losses, and some of those losses came at the hands of my own father, or at least as a result of his actions. I would like to take this opportunity to apologize. To tell you how sorry I am for the pain the Wayne family has caused this community.
If my recent incident with Harvey Dent has shown me anything, it's that I can no longer sit on the sidelines. My family's wealth was built on the suffering of others. I think it's time to repay that debt. I plan to use my resources to improve the city and make the lives of its citizens better. And to that end, a closer alliance between the GCPD and Wayne Enterprises will provide the police force with the support, with the training, and the equipment they need to make Gotham safer than it ever has been before. The GCPD will be the most technologically advanced police force in the country because the people of Gotham deserve to feel safe.
Just minutes ago, Bruce Wayne delivered a rousing speech that turned into a shocking assassination attempt on his life.
He sure does clean up well. See you soon, Brucey.
Wow, that's cool. All right, guys. That was Episode 5, City of Light. You know, these are my choices, so let's see what everybody else chose. Oh. Actually, nobody's played it yet. I guess they don't have a aggregated. So, that is the finale for Season 1. You know, how do I like the Batman Telltale games? It's all right. It's, you know, I'm still a bigger fan of Wolf Among Us and The Walking Dead. This is all right. It's, you know, Batman's not gonna die. Main characters don't really die that much in these type of things. So, because you already know the sort of the storyline already. So, but it's really neat. Definitely check it out, guys. If you have any questions,